From a tax and transfer pricing perspective, the year 2017 has indeed been an eventful year for multinational corporations operating in India. This year, we saw the rollout of GST, which is the single most important tax event for all multinationals operating in India. On an international front, we have seen significant traction on the OECD BEPS project. India, being an active follower of OECD, has brought in significant changes in its domestic law in order to align itself to various recommendations of the OECD BEPS project. On the local front, the CBDT has introduced various measures, including rationalization of safe harbor provisions, providing clarifications with respect to indirect transfers, and introduction of e-assessments in order to provide ease of doing business to the taxpayers in India. What we see now is a renewed face of the Indian Tax Department, which is more tax-savvy, well-informed, and connected to different parts of the world, and is able to roll out clarifications and changes much faster than what it was before. However, multinational corporations looking to invest in India, or who have already invested in India, are complaining that the Indian tax system lacks the fundamental feature of simplicity, certainty, and transparency, which would be conducive for the purpose of increased pace of investments in India. From an Indian transfer pricing perspective, the expectations of multinationals operating in India are as follows. Introduction of clear guidelines and clarifications with respect to critical transfer pricing issues relating to intangibles, cost contribution agreements, location savings, intra-group loans and advances, and corporate guarantees. It's important for the government to issue necessary clarifications and guidelines in relation to these contentious issues. Secondary adjustments were introduced by the Finance Act 2017. It is expected that appropriate clarifications are issued with respect to the manner of application of secondary adjustments and the period for which the interest shall be charged in relation to secondary adjustments. The government has been quite active in introduction of measures in relation to Action Plan 13 for preparation of master file and CBCR. However, it is recommended that the thresholds prescribed for preparation of master file, that is $80 million, is quite low, and it is recommended that this threshold may be revised in line with the international standards. This shall be an important step for ease of doing business in India. Rationalization of provisions in relation to thin capitalization. Currently, the threshold for application of thin capitalization rules is 30%. However, it is recommended that this threshold should be rationalized and be increased to at least 50% in line with the global standards. Further, there should be relaxation for loss-making companies and startups who are expected to have a high leverage. It is recommended that the government should take significant steps for making alternate dispute resolution mechanism like the DRP, the safe harbor provisions, and the MAP more attractive to taxpayers, such that unnecessary litigation is curtailed. These were our major budget expectations from a transfer pricing perspective. Thank you very much.